Gang.
I don't know.
Who is this?
Yeah, I was about to say, I don't know if y'all know who this person is, because I don't. I just seen the name pop up. I was like, she went crazy. 24 million views in 6 days.
Okay.
I don't know who.
Okay.
Olivia Rodrigo, driver license.
And I hope y'all got yours. If not, you're too young for this video.
It's crazy because I ain't gonna put him on blast like that. I ain't gonna put him on blast.
Get into it. Yeah, get into it.
Driver's license last week, just like we always talked about, cause you're so excited for me to finally drive up to your house.
Yeah.
But today I drove through the suburbs, crying cause you weren't around. And you're probably with that blonde girl who always made me doubt. She's so much everything I'm insecure about, yet today I drove through this.
Wow.
Woo!
Wow, this is
deep.
This is deep, because think about it.
Everybody go through that.
Yes, and the way society is moving now, social media shows us so many more things that are kind of not real.
Yeah, hey.
You know,
yeah.
Like,
they amplify, they try to push agendas on people.
Right. So being, I don't know exactly how old Olivia is or what her fan base is all about, but I feel like it's kind of like body dysmorphia or not body dysmorphia, but just like,
it's just insecurities.
Insecurities that you see, like, there's a hella beautiful females around, for sure.
Hell yeah.
Like,
but it's like, if in my head, if all they pushing is, and I'm not saying they are, but all they pushing is like, oh, females like built like strippers. And that's all they pushing, females be like, damn, I don't look like that. Oh my
God. Other things. It can be other things than the body. But because she said she's so much older than me, so.
Yeah, and she's everything that I'm insecure about.
Right.
It's like,
age just comes with time. So do not rush into anything. Please.
Listen, ladies, for real. Like, I got younger sisters, so I be like, on this kind of time, don't let nobody feel bad. Don't let nobody let you feel bad about you.
Exactly.
Ever.
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 You are you, and you can't change that. Nobody can change that. You are you, stay you. Fuck what they say.
She's everything I'm insecure about, yet today I drove through the suburbs. Cause how could I ever love someone? And I know we aren't perfect, but I've never felt this way for no one.
I'm not trying to say a positive, but she like really touching on a lot of stuff, and it's just like, if people get caught up in that first love or second love where it's like, they're not gonna find nobody else like that, or they can't find nobody that could like match that level, yeah, you made me feel bad, but it's like, you made me feel less bad than the other person. It's like, no matter, like, you were better, like, if you don't have nothing to compare to, you automatically think that person's the one. But when you go through relationships, like, okay, well, you were better than the last, I'm sure you're the one, then that don't work out, then you be like, okay, this
so
one I don't
just,
want.
Are you saying you just keep progressing?
And the way you keep progressing, because it's like, you go through these little stages, and it's just like, okay, now I know what not to deal with, and especially if you're wasting your time.
Yeah.
You know.
You know what you want, you don't want.
And so, like, that's what I'm saying. If somebody not for you, and they make you feel like shit all the time, and it's more negative than positive, leave. It's not, I'm not saying it's not that hard, because it is hard for a lot of people, but there's more out there in the world. I'll just say that. And it's crazy, because to me, when people, especially they going through something, people only tell people the bad that goes on with that person, so they only associate that person with negativity. And so if you never push that positive agenda, people ain't gonna think that positive light on that person.
At this point, just stop talking to your friends.
Like, to me, it's like, people do that, but they create more toxicity within them, because it's like, friends help guide them. If they know they're doing bad, they're not gonna tell their friends because they don't want them to get judged. Like, people don't like the feeling of being judged, so even if they're gonna do stuff in the dark, just and so they don't have to be judged. Even though they know it's wrong, they still gonna do it because it's like, well, I feel like it's okay, so I'm not gonna tell my friends. Friends is basically there to look out for you. Like, God put friends around, certain friends around you to let you know, like, how to move. Because he ain't about to be just, do this.
Right.
He put, like, obstacles in your way to let you know how to maneuver in life.
My
you
therapist
feel me?
Told me that sometimes people that are sent to you are, like, little blessings.
Mm-hmm. It's like little angels in disguise.
Right. Like,
it's just like, that's what I'm saying. So sometimes, yeah, it's cool to keep stuff from your friends, but at the same time, if you know it's not benefiting you in any way, like you're just doing it because you don't want to hear nothing, that's toxic. Like, because you let the toxic person create, give you toxic traits. It's just like one of those.
That's all around toxic.
You said forever, now I drive along past your street.
That's sad.
All my friends are tired. I miss you, but I kind of feel sorry for them, cause they'll never know you the way that I do. Yet today I drove through the suburbs and pictured I was driving home to you. And I know we weren't perfect, but I never felt this way for no one. Oh, and I just can't imagine how you could be so okay. Know that I'm good.
I'm letting you know, boo-boo, this nigga not okay.
What do you mean?
Cause niggas, how what they do is they act like they okay like first 2-3 weeks. Then a month down the line, maybe 2 months down the line, like they gonna send you that shit. You getting over them, now they start thinking about you. They gonna send you that message.
Why do y'all do that?
Cause niggas don't wanna confront feelings.
Leave us alone.
Cause like females confront their feelings, and like when the first, like that first time, right when it happens,
right.
Niggas will like wait 2-3 weeks to confront their feelings. And then hold that bottle in, and when that explodes, hey. Like the moment you're getting over that person, then it creep back in.
I thought of you while stirring the mac and cheese. Computer text.
Yes. Yes. It reminded me of how you stir your mac and cheese.
A vibe. I'm just sitting here like
it is
swaying.
It
like
it really is,
and everything she's saying is so true. Like
in my head, I feel like when you get done with somebody, you that's have to go crazy. Through this part
yeah.
of it, just so, cause that's gonna break you the fuck down.
Yup.
And after you broken down, that is gonna build you stronger. Like. After you
let
that,
next time you might not even give a fuck if you drive by the ice cream store I used to go
like through. You forget about it.
Right.
Like, you forget about, yeah, it's going to take time, but, like, you're going to stop associating places and songs and whatever you do with people that you used to talk to.
Exactly. It's just going to become another day.
Like, you're going to forget a nigga name.
who?
Huh? Mike Jones? Kill that love.
'Cause you didn't mean what you wrote in that song about me. 'Cause you said forever, now I drive along past your street. Yeah, you said forever, now I drive along past your street.
That's sad.
Fuck that street.
It was 63rd anyway. It was 63rd anyway. Like, we don't care.
I like this.
Nah,
like
this is hard. Vibe, this is hard. I like this.
I'm glad we tapped into it. But since this is our first reaction of her, first time hearing of her, comment down below and let us know a little bit more. Does she have more hits like this? Did she just start?
For real, because like, I've never heard of her. I've never heard of
never.
Her.
Never.
Like, never. Like, I seen her, like, now she popping.
Right.
let me tap in real quick for the one time. Like, and I like how it's like in the video she's just alone. 'Cause like the when you go time. Through that, you feel alone.
The whole time.
Like.
Like yes, she made up mission, her friends and like family or people or whatever, but the whole time she's just driving alone.
I wanna see how she was in the studio when she did this.
Probably just singing and like feeling just it.
Crying. Laying it out.
Ugh.
Tough.
Sometimes people gotta write a song.
And sometimes that's how people become people. Like A Boogie with the Hoodie, he said he started making music because basically somebody fucked his wife. Or his fiance or some shit like that.
That's why. Okay. comment down below. Like, comment, subscribe, push that post notification button to know when we drop a new video.
Yes, and sir.
First link and the post.
The first link in the description to be a Larry when we drop it. Whoa.
Press the first link in the description to subscribe to our Patreon.
Yes.
And don't forget to spread peace, love, and follow your dreams.
We out.